Hey, what's going on guys, Sandeep here, and I am using this MacBook Pro and sometimes I need Windows 10 on it while traveling. So I have installed Windows 10 using Bootcamp, but the Bootcamp drive has only 40 GB of storage and it is also taking storage of the MacBook. So I am going to install Windows 10 on external SSD. So I will show you how you can do that as well. And it is also applicable if you want to install Windows 10 on external SSD and want to use it with another PC. Anyway, you will learn many things today. Now you need few things to get started. First, an external SSD of course. I got this Samsung T5 with 500 gigs. And you can also get, the link is given in the video description. And second, an USB flash drive. And few USB A to C connector for your MacBook. And also you need external keyboard and mouse, and the mouse is optional but you have to get the keyboard, and if you can't navigate using keyboard then you have to get the mouse as well. Also you need to have a Windows PC, or you can install virtual Windows 10 on your MacBook, but if you can arrange a Windows laptop or PC then it would be great. Now connect your flash drive and external SSD to the Mac computer. And even if you don't get your SSD and USB device recognized here, then that's pretty okay. You need to open disk utilities. And then select your USB flash drive and erase it. And make sure the format is exFAT. Then click on erase. And do the same thing with SSD. Select it, hit erase, and the format should be exFAT, then hit erase. Now go to utilities and open Bootcamp Assistant. Then click on this action tab and download Windows support software. And select your USB flash drive. Or you can save it on desktop and then copy and paste to USB. It may take some time to download the support software. Once it is done, make sure Windows support software is present into the USB flash drive. Now, if you don't have Windows PC or can't arrange it, then you can install virtual Windows on your MacBook. You can use this VMware Fusion to install virtual Windows on your MacBook. But if you can arrange Windows PC, that would be great. Otherwise, you have to install Windows on this virtual machine. Then again, you are going to install Windows on external SSD. And that is going to be hectic. So you need to get a Windows PC or laptop or Windows virtual machine anyhow, so that we can execute few tasks. And after that, you need to get the Windows 10 ISO from the official Microsoft website. If you are on a MacBook, then you will get these options. You just have to select a Windows 10 edition and then select the language and you are good to go with download. And if you are using Windows PC to download ISO, then download options are different. If you have any issue downloading ISO file, I have a separate video for that. Now you need to download another software called Win2USB from Haslio software. Just download the free version, and all these links are given in the video description as well. So once you have ISO file and this Win2USB executable file, move these files to Windows PC or on the virtual Windows 10 on your MacBook. Now connect the external SSD to Windows PC. If you are using a different PC, then you have to take it out from MacBook and connect to PC. Or if you are using virtual Windows 10 on your MacBook, then you just have to switch between Mac to Windows. And once you have Windows 10 ISO file and this Haslio software on your Windows PC, then you just have to install this software Win2USB. I already have installed it. So after installation, you need to select the image file. Now select the Windows 10 ISO. Now you will get options to select Windows 10 version. You can choose Windows 10 Home or Education. With the free software, I mean this Win2USB free version. If you want to use Windows 10 Pro, then you need to buy this software Win2USB Pro version for $30. Otherwise, you are limited to install Windows 10 Home and the Windows 10 Education. But in the next video, I will show you how you can install Windows 10 Pro without paying $30. We will do all these things manually. But for now, let's go with Windows 10 Home. Select the first option and go with Windows 10 Home. And just click on Next. And you need to select your SSD here. Now select GPT partition style for UEFI firmware. Because all these newer MacBooks are using UEFI. So select GPT for UEFI, then hit Yes. Now you need to select legacy mode and hit the next option. And it is going to take around 15 minutes to complete the task. Once done, take out the SSD and connect to Mac computer. Now you need to restart the MacBook. While restarting, you need to press and hold Command and R key together. So press and hold Command R together till the time it enter into recovery mode. So once you get into the recovery mode, you need to select your account, enter your password. Now click on this utilities option on the top and then click on Startup Security Utility. And if you are using a MacBook that doesn't have Apple's T2 security chip, then you will get this option and you don't have to do anything. But if you are using newer MacBooks with Apple's T2 security chip, then you will get these options and you have to select Allow booting from external media under the external boot options. So allow booting from external media and then restart your Mac again. Now press and hold options key. And you will see your external SSD listed there as EFI boot. So before proceeding further, you have to connect your USB keyboard and mouse. I am using this wireless keyboard. Now select EFI boot and click on arrow button. And it will boot from your external SSD and you will see Windows logo on the screen. Now it will continue to install Windows 10. So you have to follow on-screen instructions. Use your keyboard to navigate and select the options. Let me select the keyboard layout. So if you are not comfortable navigating using keyboard, then you can connect mouse as well. On this option, select I don't have internet. And continue with limited setup. So we can do these later. Now name your PC. Provide your password. Create a password. You have to choose some security questions and provide the answers. And you can customize the privacy settings. I am going to use the default options. So you can customize all these settings if you want. You need to use external keyboard and mouse to install Windows 10 because while installing Windows 10, the keyboard and trackpad of MacBook is not going to work. So you have to get the external keyboard and mouse connected to your MacBook and use it to navigate. Now you can see that we got Windows 10 installed into MacBook on the external SSD, but the keyboard and trackpads are not working. So you need to connect your USB drive, USB flash drive, so that we can install Bootcamp support software. Use your external keyboard or mouse to navigate. Open your USB flash drive and go to Windows support folder and then Bootcamp. And then open setup.exe and click on Yes. Now it will install support software for your Windows 10 so that all the drivers can work on your Windows 10 on the MacBook. Just follow the on-screen instruction and while installing, your screen may flicker few times. Once the installation is done, you need to restart Windows 10. While restarting, press the Options key again so that you can select your external SSD. Select your external SSD again. So you have to do this process every time you switch between Mac and Windows. Now you will get to your login screen. and your keyboard and trackpads are going to work. So let me enter into Windows 10. And everything is going to work as usual. You can connect your internet and work like you do on your Windows PC. So this is how you can install Windows 10 on an external SSD to use it with Mac computers. You can install Windows 10 Home Edition for free. But if you want to install Windows 10 Pro or higher edition, then you have to get this Win2 USB Pro version for $30. But in the next video, I will show you how you can install Windows 10 Pro and higher edition for free without using Win2 USB software. I will show you all the processes manually. Whatever this software does, we will do it manually. And that's all for this video, guys. Hope this helped. If so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also, press the bell icon to get notified about new videos. And I will see you in my next video.